stars above. Without it, life is a wasted time. Look inside your heart and I look inside mine. Things look so bad everywhere. In this whole world, what is fair? We walk the line and try to see.
High-energy start to tonight's show. That was an incredible and inspiring performance by the Boys and Girls Club Youth Arts Initiative's dancers, and they have only been working on that for a week. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Boys and Girls Club of Central Minnesota's 2020 Virtual Summer Benefit, Whatever It Takes to Build Great Futures. I'm your host, Matt Nicodine, and I'm so glad you could join us from the safety of your home. At the Boys and Girls Club, safety is our number one priority. All current programming is adhering to CDC safety requirements. Everyone wears a mask and practices social distancing. And tonight, we will be following the local mask mandate. While we can't easily wear masks without muffling our voices, we have them in our pockets and we'll be maintaining a safe distance at all times, even if we have to pull out a tape measure on a regular basis. Let's give our dancers another virtual round of applause. Savannah, how does it feel to be back in the club dancing with Natalie and the dance mentor?
It's great. I really miss feeling the beat and dancing. I also miss having inspiring words come at me by Natalie and my dance friends.
We're glad to have you back too, Savannah. You belong here. And now I'd like to introduce my co-host for the evening, Jeremiah Simmons. Jeremiah, thanks for joining me in the spotlight tonight. Looks like we're about 6 feet apart.
We are 6 feet apart.
Jeremiah, tell the audience a little bit about yourself.
Well, I started going to the Boys and Girls Club when I was 10 years old. It's been an important part of my life and helped me focus on my goals. I'm happy to report that I just graduated from Stock Rapids High School, and I'm already taking classes at St. Cloud Technical and Community College.
And you're a Boys and Girls Club Career Start graduate too?
Yes, and you'll find out more about that a little later on tonight. At this time, please welcome Justin Plouffe and the Throwbacks.
Good evening, everyone. I just want to start out by saying that I'm honored to have been asked to be a part of this event tonight and have the opportunity to perform a song for all of you. I had the distinct privilege of working for Boys and Girls Club for 3 years, and I can tell you without a doubt it's one of the most rewarding jobs that I ever had. Getting to work with these young people and really watching them grow and just blossom and come out of their shell is really an incredible thing. And this program is so vital to so many kids, and is so vital and a huge part of making that possible. Again, watching these kids grow up and feeling like you got to be a part of that and help put them on this right path, that's something, like I said, it's the most rewarding thing that we could do as adults, right, is try to guide our next generation. And so again, thank you so much for being at the event tonight, for supporting Boys and Girls Club. Again, it's an incredible program, and my years again with them were some of the best. So I'd like to perform a little song for you now about life.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question, but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you have the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind. Hang it on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, in the end it's right. I hope you have the time of your life. Something unpredictable, in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Thank you very much.
Thanks to Justin Plouffe and the Throwbacks for an incredible performance. It was so cool to hear his personal connection to the Boys and Girls Club.
Yes, in fact, the Boys and Girls Club has impacted tens of thousands of lives since it opened its door in 1974. In fact, guess what? Back in college, I worked at the Boys and Girls Club too. I was a staff member at the Talahi Kid Stop, and it was there I saw how important it was for every kid, no matter what their background is, to have a positive adult role model in their life. I'm glad I was able to be there for some kids when they needed someone, and each of you watching can be there too. All you have to do is fund the need.
That's right. Please make a donation of any amount at bgcmn.org.
Jeremiah, who was the Boys and Girls Club staff that had the biggest impact on your life?
I have to say, Katie made a huge difference in my life when I first started going to the Boys and Girls Club. I had just moved to St. Cloud, and she made me feel welcome. She helped give me the confidence I needed to get involved and make friends. She motivated me to join things like Black Light Performance Group. The club opened up my horizons because it was a safe place to try new things and have new experiences.
Thanks for sharing your story, Jeremiah. And now, please welcome President and CEO of Boys and Girls Club, Mary Swingle.
Hi, guys, and thanks for hosting our show tonight. As Matt said earlier, the Boys and Girls Club of Central Minnesota opened its doors back in 1974 when we first started supporting our youth. This year, our world was turned upside down when we were notified on March 15th that schools were closing effective March 16th. Our team was so impressive and so dedicated to supporting our youth that they rallied together on a Sunday afternoon to ensure that our emergency child care programs could be up and running by 6 a.m. the next day on Monday, March 16th. These programs provided the essential child care necessary for our essential frontline workers. Our team could have stopped there, but they didn't. they knew that they could do more. So immediately they went to work on our grab and go meal program, knowing that so many of our Boys and Girls Club kids are dependent upon our clubs for their evening snacks and dinners. We knew we had to do something. So we started the Grab and Go Meal Program, where we are giving out over 5,000 dinners each week, 20,000 meals per month to the youth in Central Minnesota. Again, our team could have said, that's enough, but they didn't. They knew that they could do more. At the same time that we were running our emergency child care center and distributing our grab and go meals, we started our virtual online program. Our virtual program is reaching out to the thousands of youth that we are not able to see face to face in our emergency child care programs. In the virtual club, what we are doing is providing weekly Zoom meetings to the kids and their parents and their siblings, as well as providing fresh content every week via videos where youth are able to fine-tune their arts and STEMs and science projects, as well as engage in our career start by participating in virtual business tours. And lastly, I am so excited to announce that on June 1st, we were able to open our Kid Stop programs, as well as begin phasing in the opening of each of our three clubs, while still continuing to offer the evening dinner grab and go meal program. This last year has been tough on our team. There is no question about that, but I am so incredibly proud of this team because they rallied together to do whatever it takes to support the youth of Central Minnesota. But we couldn't do that without the generous support of each one of you. So I'm asking that you please consider to go online tonight to www.bgcmn.org and make a donation to fund the need so that we can continue to provide these essential support services to our youth and our community. Thank you. Now back to you, Matt.
Look who joined the party. It's Hazel Schoenrock, has arrived as my other co-host tonight. Hazel, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Yeah, I just turned 12 years old and I will be attending South Junior High in sixth grade this fall.
And how are you connected to the Boys and Girls Club?
I've been a member of the Southside Boys and Girls Club since first grade.
What do you like best about the Boys and Girls Club?
One of my favorite parts about the Boys and Girls Club is seeing all the different cultures represented and learning about them. It's made a big impact on how I look at the world.
And all of you watching can make a big impact on how our communities youth see the world by funding the need tonight as you enjoy the next performance by Michael Shines.
But when you days, just that little piece of me. You're still.
Exciting to be part of an event that has rallied so many amazing local artists like Michael Shines. I can't say thank you enough to these musicians for doing their part to support the Boys and Girls Club.
Next up, a message from John and Matt McDowell.
Hi, I'm Matt McDowell with McDowell Company. I'm the operations manager there, and I've been a board member with the Boys and Girls Club since 2017. I believe Boys and Girls Club makes a positive impact on youth because it fills that void where maybe some of the youth are missing something at home or missing something at school, and it fills that gap and provides those children the extra leadership and education they need to be successful. McDowell Company was excited to get involved with Career Start when it was brought to our attention. We have always tried to reach out to youth in the high schools and develop a relationship so we can educate these youth and get them ready to get into careers. With Career Start, we've been able to go directly to the source, work with the Boys and Girls Club, and make these students ready for careers, whether it's interviews, trade-based pieces, job site tours, office tours, for not only the trades, but in many of the other businesses in Central Minnesota. So we can continue to keep our youth here in Central Minnesota. So once they're educated, they're not leaving our community. They're staying here and hopefully making a positive impact on the community where they could then engage in the future as a successful adult and possibly help out the Boys and Girls Club down the line.
I feel that people should come to the club. They should invest financially. They should volunteer. They should come to the club and see what's going on and go to one of their productions and see how these young kids are just growing year by year. People come in and help them read, and you know, if they're not getting it at home, they need to get it here. They're tenacious at producing nothing but good kids that come out of there. So if we can continue to do that, it's a win for everybody. It's a great investment for the community. There's not a negative thing about it.
We are the future! You probably know him best as Stretch, so give it up for Paul Stretch Diethelm as he performs for you tonight.
And while you listen, don't forget to stretch your wallet to help us reach our Fund the Need goal of $50,000.
Hey guys, Paul Diethelm here. Gotta say I'm really humbled and very honored that the Boys and Girls Club would call me and include me in on this really great event. And so many great things about the Boys and Girls Club. But, you know, this summer, imagine what they've had to go through to keep kids busy and healthy, safe, all these things during this COVID time. Just hats off to them, and you know how great that is for the kids and how great it is for their families and community and all of that. So I thank you guys, and I got a little tune here. Live, is it going to say live in my studio? Well, it's live right now, but not while you're watching it. Anywho, let's get this thing going. Yeah, 3, 4. Mm-hmm. Sorry, just a little thirsty before I sing here.
Deb Nevesis, Vice President of Resource Development.
And I'm Amy Minerath, Senior Director of Communications. And we'd like to take a moment to thank the many sponsors who have stepped up to support the Boys and Girls Club in one of the most difficult years in our nation's history during COVID-19.
Our sponsors have contributed more than $75,000 to support the important mission of the Boys and Girls Club through the summer benefit. We can't say thank you enough to our sponsors, our partners for the future, and our entire community for your ongoing support during this crisis.
Your support has helped us prove to our kids and families that hope is indeed not canceled, that the generous spirit of this community will prevail over dark times, and the future is still bright.
And now, please listen to our sponsors as they share their perspective on how the Boys and Girls Club makes an impact on our community.
Hello, thank you for joining us for this year's summer benefit for the Boys and Girls Club. We're sorry we can't be in person. We're PCI, we're the premier sponsor of this event and have been for the last number of years. We're proud to sponsor this event because of all the great work that the Boys and Girls Club does in this community to take care of our children by offering food, by providing all the services they need, and it's even more critical during this time of the pandemic to help these children that need us every single day.
And again, please help fund the need for the Boys and Girls Club. They provide so many meals for kids in need, you know, from breakfast to lunch to dinner, and the need is there more so than ever. So please join us in supporting the Boys and Girls Club.
Hi, I'm John Pearson, president of Freightliner of St. Cloud. At Freightliner of St. Cloud, we are proud to support the Boys and Girls Club because we see the importance of their commitment to our area youth with meals and care, but also their variety of programs to assist in education, creativity, and character building throughout the important developmental years. Thanks to the Boys and Girls Club of Central Minnesota.
Hello, my name is Mike Markman, Region President for U.S. Bank here in St. Cloud. These days, it's hard to predict what the day will bring, but there's one thing we know for sure, and that is the Boys and Girls Club of Central Minnesota is here to help our youth and their families. During this pandemic, the club continues to provide tremendous impact for our youth in Central Minnesota by providing character, leadership development, education, and lasting health and life skills. Both families and our business community are benefactors of this amazing organization. U.S. Bank believes communities are stronger when they are connected through accessible spaces that the Boys and Girls Club provides. There's power in community, which is why U.S. Bank has been a proud supporter of the Boys and Girls Club for nearly three decades. We invite you to fund this program as well. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Jeff Gao, CEO of Marco. We're proud to be an event sponsor of Boys and Girls Club's 2020 Virtual Summer Benefit. The Boys and Girls Club does great things for so many youth and their families. The club is a safe place for kids to go after school and in the summer, then get a meal, get help with homework, play sports, and participate in the arts. The club makes our community stronger, and I'd like to invite you to join us in supporting them with a donation to Fund the Need at bgcmn.org. Thanks for helping our kids and our community.
Auto Value Parts Stores is proud to sponsor Boys and Girls Clubs of Central Minnesota because we believe in the great work they do for youth and families. Hi, I'm Corey Bartlett, President and CEO of APH. We know the community in which our employees and customers live and work is stronger because of the Boys and Girls Club. They're providing childcare, meals, homework help, arts and sports, and even career development programs. Boys and Girls Club is doing whatever it takes to build great futures, and we encourage you to support their mission this evening with your Fund a Need gift. Thanks for being here tonight.
So, Jeremiah, back to Career Start. I heard that you're one of the first youth to successfully graduate from the Boys and Girls Club's Career Start program.
Yes. Matt, I am so thankful for the opportunity to have participated in the Career Start program because it gave me the tools I needed to focus on my career goal to enter the healthcare industry. And I can't say thank you enough to the Boys and Girls Club staff and donors who have made the Career Start program possible.
This is the perfect time to introduce the Career Start highlight graduation video. Don't forget to open your wallets as you hear about how the Boys and Girls Club and the Career Start program are helping youth like Jeremiah and Antonia achieve their goals.
Hi, my name is Jeremiah Simmons. I've been a member of the Boys and Girls Club for 5 or 6 years, and I'm graduating from Stock Rapids Rise High School.
Hi, my name is Antonia Riley. I've been going to the Boys and Girls Club for about 12 years now. I have graduated from Apollo High School February 28th. I am looking to get my diploma soon.
So the Boys and Girls Club Career Start program has impacted me by providing me with a support system of those local here in town that I daily talk to and I'm able to kind of share with. And I like that it's a good support system for me and also for others in the program, because sometimes people, they may not have that support system. And then college can be discouraging because it is something scary and it's a new experience.
The Boys and Girls Club Career Start has helped me because it's helped me with job readiness, teamwork, and communication skills. Also meeting new people and getting out there more.
I plan to study pre-nursing. I want to become a registered nurse. And with their pre-nursing program, I'm able to start as an LPN and work my way up. My future career goals will probably involve more schooling because I do want to accrue my bachelor's in nursing and my master's. And that's the main goal, is to keep going to school for nursing. So just more schooling.
At St. Cloud Technical Community College, I am planning to study social working for the state. My future career goal is to become a social worker and also somehow become a kindergarten teacher. I want to give back to the community, and I want kids and teens that's out there to feel like they have somebody to talk to and that they have somebody to come to and that they can rely on somebody instead of following bad situations or bad habits that they have seen their whole life when it comes to kids that don't really have anybody or kids up in the system.
And I would like to see myself with my master's in nursing to be a nurse practitioner. I would like to work for a hospital, and I would like to work for a children's hospital. I've been thinking of it a little bit more because there's so many different fields of nursing, and I can see myself working with children a lot in the hospital. What excites me most about my future is I have lots of options and a good team behind me. I have like different school options, and also with learning more and getting more education, I know that I have a really good future ahead of me. And I like that I have a support team behind me with Career Start, because it really excites me to know like I'm not in this alone and I have people to talk to and they can help guide me through it all.
I want to thank everybody who has chipped in and put in something to help with this program. It means a lot to me because some kids can't afford to do stuff like this, and also some kids are really smart out there and actually pushing and trying to be better people. And that's why I really appreciate this opportunity.
So I'd like to thank everyone who has been a part of this Career Start program. Without your help, this wouldn't be able to go on and change many people's lives. This really does impact me a lot because it takes a burden off of myself and also my family. And it provides a good support system that many may not have.
My name is Anthony O'Reilly, and my great future started right here at the Boys and Girls Club.
My name is Jeremiah Simmons, and my great future started here at the Boys and Girls Club.
Next, we are so excited to introduce Janelle Kendall as she sings Goodbye Yellow Brick Road.
Hi, my name is Janelle Kendall. I'm the Stearns County Attorney. Thanks for inviting me to be part of this fundraiser for the Boys and Girls Club. For years, we have known that that is a good place for kids. It's a place they can go for a meal, for a game, but it's a place they can go to have positive interaction with the community. And positive interaction early in kids' lives matters a lot. Thank you to the Boys and Girls Club for what you do, and thanks for inviting me. Here's a song about some kids who didn't have such a great experience. Society, how you can't plant me in your path. penthouse. I'm going back to my plow. After the howl and old owl in the woods, hunting the horny back toad. Oh, I'll finally decide where my future lies beyond the yellow brick road. So what do you think you'll do then? I bet they'll shoot down your plane. You take you a couple of vodka and tonics to get back on your feet again. Maybe you'll get a replacement. There's plenty like me to be found. Mongrels who ain't got a penny, sniffing for tidbits like you on the ground. Ah, ah. So goodbye, yellow brick road, where the dogs of society howl. House. I'm going back to my plow. After the howling old owl in the woods, hunting the horny back toad. Oh, I'll finally decide where my future lies beyond the yellow brick road. Society howl. You can't plant me in your penthouse. I'm going back to my plow. After the howling old owl in the woods, hunting the horny back toad. Oh, I'll finally decide where my future lies. Decide where my future lies. I'll finally decide in my future lives beyond the yellow brick
Even though we've paused the in-person Elvis Lives summer benefit, Deb Nebesis and Amy Minerath have assured us that Elvis will be back in 2021.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. We just wanted to remind y'all that Elvis will be back in 2021. So we'd appreciate it if you'd all mark your calendars for August 5th, 2021. For the summer benefit, Elvis Lives. And in the meantime, please help us build our dreams for youth by funding the need. It's now or never, so now's the time. It's now or never, so go online. It's now or never. Don't make me plead. It's now or never, so fund the need.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Elvis has left the building. So many families have been possibly impacted by the important work that the Boys and Girls Clubs do in the community. The following parents are frontline workers for CentraCare who were able to keep our health industry running during this school closure, thanks to the Boys and Girls Club's Emergency Services Child Care Program.
My name is Kim Montour, and my son started with the Boys and Girls Club Kids Stop program
last summer.
My name is Danielle Fribley, and my daughter has attended KidStop programs run by the Boys and Girls Club since she was in kindergarten.
My name is Cheryl Peterson. We've been going to KidStop for roughly about 5 years, and I work at the St. Cloud Hospital. I am a certified cardiovascular technician, and I work in the Heart Center.
We've actually been the front line for COVID questions, so when patients call in, they reach us in my department, and we get them to the nurse, or we get them scheduled.
I am a nurse with CentraCare, and her dad is a plumber. So throughout the stay-at-home order, we were both working the entire time. It was kind of scary when we first got that stay-at-home order. It was on a Saturday or a Sunday, and it was starting that next day. Kind of nerve-wracking to try to say, where is our child going to go tomorrow for us to still be able to go to work? Our other daughter goes to a daycare center, which doesn't take school-aged kids. So that, again, nerve-wracking. So I saw something online that KidStop was still going to be allowing essential workers to come. And so it got signed up for that right away and felt confident in that decision because it was a place that she knew and that we already felt comfortable with.
And I was very nervous that I wouldn't be able to do my job because it's hard to have a job as a single mom. And then also you have to have your child home all day. You have to make sure they get their schoolwork done. The Boys and Girls Club, they emailed me right away to let me know that I could use their services as a healthcare worker. And I'm so grateful for it because one, I did not have to worry about doing his distance learning. They did it for him. They helped him with it. So he was successful. As far as distance learning went, I know a lot of other parents had issues with that. I did not have to worry about that at all or stress about it. So I could really focus on my job during the day. I had no worries about my son. I knew he was in capable hands. I knew he was getting education. So I could focus on being on that front line. I don't know what I would have done without the services of the Boys and Girls Club during COVID at all.
The Boys and Girls Club's emergency program through the school closure made a huge impact on my family, just knowing that my child is going to be safe. I trust the staff there.
The kids are all wearing masks, and every time I pick up, kids are following that guideline. She was able to get most of her schoolwork done. There was plenty of support there for the students, which I think was important because with being at work all day, it's a lot to get home and do supper and bath and bedtime and a full day of schoolwork.
I encourage anyone out there to please fund the Boys and Girls Club. It's a great, wonderful program.
Please consider making a gift to the Boys and Girls Club.
You know, I also just wanted to ask you guys if you could please consider making a generous gift to fund the need for, you know, supporting the Boys and Girls Club. They're doing everything they can to help support our community during COVID-19. It would be much appreciated.
It warms my heart to introduce our next guest, Kendall Spells. We all watched her grow up in the Boys and Girls Club. Thanks to the mentorship she received at the club, she has grown into the amazing young woman you see before you today. Welcome to the show, Kendall.
Thank you for having me.
So, Kendall, how old were you when you started attending the Boys and Girls Club, and how did you get involved?
Officially, I was 5, because that's the official answer, but my older brother and sister had been members, and so I'd always kind of been hanging around trying to wait till it was my turn since I missed my brother and sister, but officially then, and just because it was an awesome place for me to be safe with my brother and sister and have a place where my mother didn't have to worry about where we were, who we were with, and knowing that we could get fed, that was a wonderful place for us to be as kids.
What was your club experience like, and how did it have an impact on your life?
My life was definitely forever changed by the Boys and Girls Club because it allowed me to have a certain set of stability and routine. You know, I went to school every day. I went to the Boys and Girls Club every day. I got help with my homework every day. I was able to read every day. I was able to be on a routine. And for me as an adult now, I realize how important routines are, just being on a schedule and having a lot of support, how much of a difference that makes in what I was able to accomplish for myself.
What do you think your life would have been like if you hadn't been involved in the club?
When you have idle time, things can definitely lead to less positive outcomes and interactions. And growing up, a lot of my friends were doing different things that I didn't do because I was at the Boys and Girls Club. And the Boys and Girls Club allowed me to have an avenue to be able to make good choices. And that's why it was very important for me to be here.
How did the club help prepare you for your post-secondary education?
So many things, I will say. Let's say First, being able to help me with my homework to get there. There was a lot of times when I was doing my math or I was doing any history homework or there was anything that I didn't understand, I was always able to get a little extra help. And then when it came to applying for schools and figuring out where I wanted to go, it was always awesome for me because a lot of the staff are college students oftentimes and volunteers, and speaking with them about their experiences and being a part of the Youth of the Year, I was able to also get a scholarship for school, so that helped me cover my application fees. And when I did finally decide on St. Ben's, the, you know, to reserve my spot essentially, and so I wouldn't have been able to afford it otherwise.
What are you doing now, and how did the club help prepare you for your current career?
So, the Boys and Girls Club helped me prepare for my current career. It's actually really funny. I work at Preferred Credit, PCI for the shorthand, and the Winfelds are huge supporters of the Boys and Girls Club, and I work as a client processing specialist there. And with that, I feel like the Boys and Girls Club has helped me with my communication skills, my person-to-person skills, and just learning how to, one, fill out an application. Career launch was something that was very important in helping me learn how to apply and do interviews because I get super nervous. And so I was able to be prepared for that. And I feel like I wouldn't have these skills today had I not gone through those programs.
Thank you, Kendall. We are so proud of you and your great accomplishments. And we're so happy to be able to stay connected through the unfolding of your great future.
Well, thank you. I'm happy to be here and to be a part of it.
The meal program is probably the most important component of the Boys and Girls Club's programming. What better way to reach a kid's heart than through their stomachs? For nearly 20 years, the Boys and Girls Club has been providing meals to kids.
It all started with the peanut butter and jelly sandwich program, and now it's grown to serve over 120,000 meals per year. Out of 3 Boys and Girls Club commercial kitchens, and 11 area kid stops in the summer months.
Let's watch how the Boys and Girls Club is working to feed kids during COVID-19.
Within 2 weeks after school closed due to COVID-19, Boys and Girls Club staff launched a grab-and-go meal distribution program. This program is getting 5,000 meals out to kids in need every week. Meals are available for pickup on Mondays and Thursdays throughout the summer at the Southside, Roosevelt, and Eastside clubs from 3 to 4 p.m. and include 3 days of supersized snacks and dinners on Mondays and 4 days of snacks and dinners on Thursdays.
We were able to step in right away and still provide meals to our families, in which most of those families rely on our meal program that we have here in the club. So being able to still fulfill our mission, which is serving those that need us most, and being able to reach out to our families and say, you know, times are hard, life is tough right now, but we're still here for you. It's been overall amazing, and just seeing how when the families come and pick up the meals, how their eyes light up, and we still have that interaction with them, and we're still able to be there for them throughout this whole crisis that we're in right now.
Hello, my name is Robbie, and this is Oliver. He's been attending to the Boys and Girls Club for over a year now, up until the COVID-19 closure. And we've been coming here also to enjoy the grab and go of bags. And that's been great help for our family because of no school and also, like, you know, work situation. So it's like we appreciate it so much. And the kids, they enjoy it very much. It's a picnic every time they open up a bag. It just, like, you know, all sorts of, like, you know, goodies. Two of my neighbors, they are actually they're going to work, so they don't have time to pick up the grab and go meal. So I've been taking extra bags, and Miss Dominic's been, like, so grateful for, like, having us taking extra, so we can actually share my those bags in my neighborhood parents also.
It's been fun doing the grab and go food meal thing, because we see some of the staff and we talk to them and we bring stuff and show them. And then we pick up the bags, and when we come home, when we eat it, it's really fun because we get to see, like, the stuff that we used to eat at the club.
families. Quite a few of our families are laid off right now. They're not seeing an income. And so they have just written us letters, given us phone calls, and even personally just came up here to thank us for what we're doing because they don't know what they would do without it. So I'm very happy to be part of Boys and Girls Club and also part of what we're doing out in the community. So
great future start here at the Boys and Girls Club.
Hazel, I must say that I'm excited to hear you share your singing talent with us tonight. But first, why don't you tell us how the Youth Arts Initiative programming has impacted you?
Yeah, being in the Boys and Girls Club's Youth Arts Initiative has helped me make a lot of new friends and create strong bonds with staff. I've painted, I've done spoken word, I've sung at showcases, and I've even co-emceed before. Thanks to the club, I've become more creative and confident in my abilities, and I know that if I make a mistake, club staff will help me fix it, and I will learn from it. I'm excited to sing Rainbow tonight because I think we're all stuck in a storm right now, but it helps to know that there's a rainbow just ahead of us. And that's what the Boys and Girls Club is, a rainbow that helps kids get through the storm of their lives so they can see the sunshine of their bright future ahead of them. When it rains, it pours, but you didn't even notice. It ain't raining anymore. It's hard to breathe when all you know is the struggle of staying above the rising waterline. While the sky is finally opened, the rain and wind stop blowing. But you're stuck out in the same old storm again. You hold tight to your umbrella. It's darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. What I see, you'll be blinded by the color. Yellow, red, and orange, and green, and at least a million others. So tie up the bow, take off your coat, and take a look around. 'Cause the sky is finally opened, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old storm again. Hold tight to your umbrella, 'cause darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. Oh, tie up the bow, take off your coat and take a look around. Everything is all right now, 'cause the sky is finally opened, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old storm again. You let go of your umbrella, darling, I'm just trying to tell ya that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. Yeah, there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. It'll all be alright.
Thank you all for joining us for Boys and Girls Club's 2020 Virtual Summer Benefit, Whatever It Takes to Build Great Futures. Your support has helped me launch my great future in healthcare.
And you've empowered me to be more confident in my creative abilities.
We know that everyone has struggled in some significant way during COVID-19. And the storm isn't over. But as Hazel said, there's a rainbow just ahead of us. We need you to help provide that rainbow of hope for the kids served by the Boys and Girls Club. We have a hefty goal of $50,000 for Fund the Need. The need to provide 5,000 meals per week to kids in need. The need to provide positive adult mentors for kids to help them realize their own potential. The need to provide social and emotional support for kids, especially during these difficult times. The need to support families who may be in crisis right now. The need to chart a path to successful high school graduation with a plan for a great future. The need to do whatever it takes to build a great future for the youth in our community. The need is great. Please fund the need tonight to support the Boys and Girls Club in their efforts to ensure a great future for our community.
Great futures start with your gift.
Great futures start here.
You hold tight to your umbrella. It's darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a